There are many ways by which you can track your personal tasks, and one of the best ones would be to track them in Excel. If you look at this particular task list on your screen, you can see that just by the click of a button, we can update the status of a particular task, and I also get to know what is the progress on the overall tasks. Now, a question would be that, is it very difficult to make such a tracker? Not at all. Let's get started and learn how to create this particular tracker. So first of all, let me just put down all the things that I need in this particular task tracker. First thing would be task number, task details, then I need priority, and then status. Let's say I want to make a table of 10 tasks. I'll just put down the numbers. In the priority column, I'll do a validation and then put the three options of low, medium, and high. So I'll go to data, data validation, list, low, medium, high. Click OK, and I can see a drop down from here for the three options. I'll just copy this cell and paste in all the 10 tasks. Now in the status column also, you can either put down a drop down which says done, or you can manually type it every time it's done, or else if you want to make it more convenient, the easiest way would be to put a checkbox. In order to add a checkbox, you need to have the developer tab in the ribbon. Now in order to get the developer tab in your ribbon, you need to go to your Excel preferences, then click on ribbon and toolbar, and here on the right hand side you can see that there is a developer option available. Just click on it and save it. You can now see that a developer option is available in your ribbon. Click on it and you will get the various options in the developer tab. Now in the status cell, I want a checkbox which I click every time I complete a task. Now let me just click on the checkbox option. Once I've selected a checkbox, I can click anywhere and this checkbox is pasted onto the Excel sheet. Now what I can do is that I'll first of all change this message and say that click once completed. Let me just take this and adjust it to the first cell. I'll copy this particular checkbox and paste it 10 times. So now I have these 10 checkboxes. Let me just adjust them to the particular cells. Now once this is done, I also want to make sure that every time I click on a checkbox, that status is recorded somewhere. So what we need to do is that we'll right click on one of the checkboxes and go to format control. Here we need to put a cell link. Let's put the cell link as H7 for the first one and say okay. I'll see that every time I click it, it gives me a true response, and now if I leave it unchecked, it'll give me a false response. Let me assign this for all the other tasks as well. Once this is done, you can name this particular column as something like updated status. Now next, what I want to do is that I want to assign weightages to the priority. What I essentially mean to say is that I do not want the overall completed percentage to be updated the same way for high, medium, and low priority task. Ideally, a high priority task should update the overall completed percentage by a higher percentage as compared to medium, and medium should update it by a higher percentage as compared to lower. So let me just assign those weightages first. Let's say for low, I assign a weightage of 1, medium is 3, and high is 5. Now next, what I want is that this weightage is assigned to a particular task as soon as the entry is done and as soon as the priority for that particular task is set. Let me put down any random task and then set a priority for it, high. Now here I'll just put a column which says weightage, and in that column what I'll do is that I'll do a lookup of the priority against my table. Now you can see that as soon as I change the priority, the weightage also automatically changes over here. But on top of this, I also want to put some validations which make sure that if these two columns do not have any entry, this weightage remains black. What I essentially mean is that I need both task details and priority to be set to give the weightage. So I will use an if or function in order to set this validation. So what I'm trying to say is that I'll put down if or my task detail, which is len of E7 is equal to 0, comma len of F7, which is the priority, is equal to 0, then in that case, I would want a blank cell, else this is the result that I need. Now I'll copy this particular function to all the other cells. But before that, I want to make sure that I have locked this particular table inside the VLOOKUP function. For that, I'll just put the dollar signs before the table array. Here we go. Now let me just try with any other cell. And you can still see that the weightage has not been given. Now as soon as I put down the priority over here or change the priority here, you can see that the weightage also changes accordingly. Next, what I want to do is that I want to add a task weightage status, which essentially means that I should get the weightage here in a column which is updated only when the status is completed. Let me call this column as updated weightage. Here I'll put a function of if equal to if the updated status is equal to true, then my result would be the weightage, or else it would be a zero. Now here I want to put a validation that if the weightage column does not have any value, it will leave me a blank value over here in updated weightage. So what I'll do is that I'll put down equal to if len of the weightage, which is I7 is equal to 0, then give me a blank cell, else I should get the updated weightage, and copy it in the entire task list. Now let's test it. In order to test it, what we'll do is that we'll simply click on one of the completed status. So you can see that the updated weightage is also updated to 5. And if I click on the other one, it's also updated as well. Now, in order to get the percentage of the overall tasks completed, I will need a total of the weightages and a total of the updated weightages, and then divide it to get the percentage. So let me just put a total. It will be equal to sum of the entire weightage, and then total updated, this one will be equal to sum of the updated weightage over here. Now we need to create a progress bar for the tracker, and for that let's just first of all merge a few cells like this. Now in this merge cell, what we're going to do is that we're going to do simply equal to the total updated divided by the total. Now you can see that as and when I click any of the task is completed, this ratio also changes over here, and it ranges between 0 and 1. 0 being no task is completed and 1 being all the tasks have been completed. You can also see that if I try and add more tasks over here, automatically the total also changes basis the priority that I have provided over here. Let's say I change the priority of this particular task to low, the total will change to 7, and if I change it to high, it will make it 11. And then accordingly, once you're clicking completed on these particular tasks, the progress will range from 0 to 1. Now in order to make this particular progress bar, we need to use conditional formatting. So let's go over here, go to conditional formatting, data bars, and go to more rules. The new pop-up window that opens up, in the minimum one, you select a number and maximum also a number. And the maximum value you select it as 1. You can choose any particular color that you want for your positive values. Of course, there are no negative values, so you can leave it as is. And then press OK. Then what you can do is that you can change the format of this particular cell to percentage, leave it to 0 decimal places, and press OK. Now you can see that as and when a task is getting completed from here, the progress bar is also changing. I'll try to add a few more tasks. And let's see how the progress bar changes. The last thing to do is to format your task list and then just hide some of the columns and cells that have got all the calculations, and your task tracker is ready. Believe me, it should not take you more than 15 to 20 minutes to make this particular tracker. And if in case you need a sample of this tracker, you'll get the link to download the Excel sheet in the description below. Thank you so much for your time. Until next time, bye-bye.